the rabbit hole for Lucia. We're gonna have to do it because it's just, this is how it be. I should do something myself. This might only make things worse, but I still won't stick my neck into it.
Demo, nantonaku souyu ki ga shiteita.
Yeah.
Wakatta.
She looks at me again without waiting for another question. To be blunt, is class rep really a clean freak?
どうしてそう思う?
I'm not sure. Would it be too cheesy to say something in her eyes told me?
だいぶ.
Sorry. Shizuru is calm and blunt as always. But that's why she can get along so well with someone as fiery as Class Rab. I tell her everything that happened, and that I want her to help in getting Chihaya and Class Rab to make up.
Kotaro!
お前はルチアの友人なのか? I'd like to think I am. What? I'd like to think I am? Fuck!
友人の友人だから、私とも友人だ。Don't
do that to me. I thought I was already your friend.
そうだったか、これはうっかり。
Shizuru scratches her head adorably. Then she gazes at me. As if judging my worth? No. Trying to figure out my true intentions. So for a short while, I simply gaze back at her. She's telling me not to ask about class rep merely out of curiosity.
話してもいい? ずっとルチアの友人でいてくれるのなら
No problem, I'll stick with her forever. I'm not going to space after all.
宇宙?
Yeah, exactly. Ah, sorry, inside joke. You know, we have that going on. After school, Shizuru and I meet up again. There's a crepe stand in the park, so we buy something here. There. At this time of the day, the park is full of kids in the going home club, running around to get the most out of their last few minutes here. Pudding, strawberry, and anchovies. What do you want?
Anchovy!
Whoa, Shizuru, I didn't expect you to like bitter foods.
おいしいぞ! Kotaro も一口食べるか?
No. Shizuru stuffs her cheeks with the anchovy crepe. Then she looks at me. Anchovies are normally pickled in salt and used in a pizza. Apparently, putting cream on them makes them a nice sweet and salty flavor. Just watching her eat makes me want to try it. No, no, it's okay.
そうか、残念。
Huh. Shizuru, you've eaten with class rep before, right?
ある! ランチにサンマのフルーツサンドをごちそうした!
I'll question the sanity of that combination later. The point is, class rep had no trouble eating something you made, right? Konohana Lucia called cats and flowers filthy. Would someone like that really be able to eat food that someone else made? Actually, how could she even eat at the cafeteria?
ルチアは別に潔癖症なんかじゃない。
No shit! It's just a front! Then why does she tell everyone she is? Because it fits their expectations. It's easier to explain it that way. Shizuru lowers her head. Then she looks down, thinking hard about what she should tell me. She wears gloves all day long. That can't be comfortable. Why would she go that far if she isn't a clean freak? I don't know, probably because there's a different other reason. No meaning? Okay, if that had no meaning, why would she keep replacing them? Why would she wear them in the first place? That means they have a meaning. There is a purpose to them. Oh yeah, that's right. She wouldn't have so many pairs of gloves on her if they didn't have a purpose. Stop lying to me. I thought those gloves were hiding some kind of secret, and eventually I forced her to take them off. You even had an extra pair of gloves for her to wear. So don't fucking lie to me. I remember that. There was nothing weird about them. In fact, they were beautiful. Because it's filthy? But you already said that wasn't about... Okay, whatever. Wait a minute. Doesn't that make her a clean freak? Yeah, okay. Her hands are pretty. What is Zero trying to say? If she's not a clean freak and her gloves don't mean anything, then what? It's almost like she's lying. I can hear the voices of children playing. Some of them are running around chasing each other. Some of them are singing together. I can also hear balls being kicked around and someone playing a pianissimo? What? Fucking piano? Have you seen sunflowers before? What happened to the piano? If you water them every day, they slowly grow taller, and by summer they'll have bright yellow flowers. After that, they make lots and lots of seeds. Grow bigger. Much, much bigger. Show us how many seeds you can make. You have to compete with all of your friends after all. Sensei told me sunflowers make tons of seeds. So when my sunflower makes seeds, and tons of other sunflowers start growing, and that repeats over and over and over, wouldn't that fill the whole world with sunflowers? Sunflowers symbolize happiness. Happiness can cover the world. And if the very first seed was mine, that would be so wonderful. When I imagined that, my world became filled with a field of sunflowers. A bright blue sky. Clouds, like white cotton. A field of sunflowers making waves in the wind. A strong wind carrying heat with it. That's the ideal world I imagined. A ladybug crawls up one of my leaves. Ew. It's cute. I poke it and it rolls over and falls off the leaf. Sorry, I'll put you back. I pick up the ladybug and put it back on the leaf. But it rolls off yet again. What a clumsy bug. It's probably playing dead because I scared it. Such a waste. I'm crawling all the way up to that leaf. It can fly. Could I bend the leaf so that it would stay up? Then I could just leave it and it would eventually stop playing dead. I tried gently bending the leaf toward an angle where it might be able to support the ladybug. This is hard. The sunflower's leaves won't do what I want them to. That. It was such a strong bulky leaf, but it snapped off. That causes the ladybug to fall off and land on the ground again. It lies face up, not moving a muscle. None of its little legs are crawling out at the air. Not a single one. I feel very worried when I notice that. Then I notice the leaf I broke off is curling up and wilting in my hand. It was so bright and strong before. Why? Then the huge flower starts drooping, as if bowing to me. There's no wind blowing on it, so why? If you keep bowing like that, you'll break out your stem. I hurriedly prop up that huge flower, like holding up a person fainting from anemia. But the petals fall off one by one, all losing their color. Why? Why? I understand now. That ladybug wasn't playing dead. It really was dead. And now the sunflower is wilting and dying too. Why? The sunflower slowly curls up and turns dark brown in my hands. As if someone cruelly trod it into the mud. It crumbles into little pieces. My hands look like puddles of dirty water, thick with rotten filth. On top of that, pus starts oozing out from my hands. Ew, what? I don't know what to do with these tainted hands. Rubbing them off on my clothes doesn't work, so I try shaking the mud off. Then the mud is flung off, lands on several other flowers, and melts through them. I can hear the crumpling up and falling over. Oh, fuck. Wait, did she have, like, some fucking, like... So it's, like, some power or something. That's why she wears gloves, so, like, she doesn't kill people? And, like, either age them or... like, sucks their life force or whatever? What is this? What happened to my hands? This filthy pus-like substance oozes out endlessly. A puddle forms as it drips from my hands. No. This is filthy. It's scary. Stop it. Oh. So when she's saying it's filthy, she's talking to her about herself then? I don't know why she wouldn't touch a ball, though. It's not like the ball will disintegrate. Oh, because it would kill the fucking flowers. That's why. I want to wipe off that filthy liquid, but there's nothing I can wipe it off with. So I fling my hands around wildly. That sends more filthy drops flying into the air. And every sunflower they land on bends over, snaps, and crumbles. They're all lying flat on the ground. Before I know it, the bright, lush field around me had turned into a muddy wasteland. All the once beautiful sunflowers lie down in the mud, slowly melting in a thick soup. It looked as if the sunflowers were distancing themselves from me. More keep falling. As if chains of sunflower dominoes has been started where I was standing. The field of sunflowers was nowhere to be seen anymore. There's only one carpet of rotting sunflowers, knocked down into the filthy mud. And then I found just one sunflower that was barely managing to stand up within the filth. I was happy, I ran toward it without thinking, to make sure it was okay. Don't touch it. I jumped back at the boy's voice, and stand still in the darkness. No, it's not a boy's voice. It might be a girl's. I can't hear the words, but I can feel the whispering. I can't blame that voice for being mad at me. After all, the sunflowers rotted because of my filthy hands. If I touch that last sunflower, it'll rot too. Since it's just another sunflower. I bite my lip and look down. I suppress my desire to touch the sunflower, and I clench both hands. Then I quietly walk away. I can't shake the feeling that this last sunflower will die too, if I don't get away from it. Then I start running. Behind me, I can finally hear everyone's happy voices coming back. Because I didn't touch it, the last sunflower was just fine. That's why everyone's smiling again. After running through the darkness, I end up in an inorganic place, filled with white fluorescent light. This is my bathroom. I stick my tainted hands into the running water so cold it hurts, and wash them viciously. The clear stream of water almost immediately turns filthy and muddy as I wash my hands with it. The porcelain sink becomes covered in that filthy spray. Scrubbing. This water is so cold it hurts, but it's still not cleaning my hands at all. That's because you should be using hot water. Fuck. I wash. But the filthy pus keeps oozing out. Where's this stuff coming from? Is it oozing out of the wrinkles in my palms? Or from under my fingernails? I grab a toothbrush and thoroughly, diligently, obsessively scrub all 10 of my nails. But it doesn't help. Making my nails cleaner doesn't help. I have to dig out the source. Oh god, please don't cut yourself. As I do that, the sink fills with the filthy water, eventually overflowing. It starts bubbling, and the drain blocks up, and the filth rapidly fills the whole sink. Then something, stuck in the drain, pops out into the sink. 4 dead goldfish. No, I remember. There's 5 of them. They're all floating upside down. Blubbing. The drain makes horrible noises as it tries to spit out something even worse. I don't have to see it to know what it is. I know it's a dead rabbit. Why the fuck is there a dead rabbit in here? It's not my fault I didn't kill them. Oh, it's probably over. Like, dead pets. Fucking god. But if I hadn't approached and petted that rabbit, it wouldn't have died. It would still be alive. Everyone would still be smiling. So maybe it is my fault. Tears fall from my eyes as I feel a mix of anger and sadness as the dead goldfish swirl around my hands and continue washing. This pus really is oozing out of my hands. I have to get it all out, but how? By digging and digging and digging until I get every last drop out. Okay. Oof, no thank you. I don't want to hear about this. I grab a razor and put the blade to my palm. I'll cut open this useless skin. Then it should all flow out of me. Yo, how did he fucking notice, like, if she'd been cutting herself or not? What? There's no way he didn't notice. I push the blade down. The sharp pain pulls me back to reality. Please tell me she actually never did cut herself. That would be terrible. How long have I been washing my hands? Oh, it's really cute in here. Forever and ever and ever and ever. I've never stopped washing my hands there. I turn off the water, curse and wipe my hands with the towel. My hands ache from the cold water, almost like frostbite. I clench my hands together to warm them up and to crush that pain. Then I lean back against the wall and slowly slide down to the floor in a heap. I cover my face with my cold hands and groan. That adorable cat, its softness and warmth, Otori Jahaya's smile as she held it out to me. In her broken, crushed expression after I knocked her to the ground, cold, hard ground with my own hands. I scratch at my face. I look at my clear white hands. Then tears fall from my swollen eyes once again. Why do you choose to be like that? Fuck off! You shitter. Whoa. What? Jaya, did you ever raise sunflowers in elementary school? Did they grow okay? I swear to God. Kotaro, don't! No! Don't do this! Please, God! No! Did everyone in the class have the same luck? Exactly. Like you said, they had bad luck. Class rep also had bad luck with their sunflowers. Jaya realizes I called her out to the courtyard to talk about class rep and looks very displeased. Being fucking passive aggressive about it counts. It wasn't just sunflowers, her bad luck continued. Everyone in her class took turns feeding a goldfish. But the day after class rep fed it, it died. This is terrible. One day she volunteered to take care of a rabbit, and the day after it passed away. That's right, all those things can happen through sheer bad luck, no matter how well one takes care of them. Glassref just experienced all that bad luck in a very short span of time. The cruel social structure of young children blamed her for all of that. They said her hands were filthy and tainted. That all sunflowers she touched wilted, and any animal she touched died. That actually might be a thing, though. Let's be honest here. We live in a fucking superhuman world. That's probably, a legit thing. Chizuru emits a fucking gas that paralyzes people. Or at least familiars. Or weakens them, or whatever it was. That was when she started worrying about cleanliness. But rumors like that don't go away easily. No matter how clean her hands were, the other children never forgave her. That was when class ref started to avoid touching things directly. Living things. Gunahana Lucia is so stubborn about wearing those gloves that everyone assumes that she's a clean freak. And she claims everything is too filthy to touch. But it's not that flowers or cats or humans are filthy. Her own hands are filthy, that's why she doesn't want to touch them. No, that's why she can't touch them. Yeah, I still think it's a little more than just that. Like, it's a nice story to be like, oh, it was just all a fucking coincidence. No, I think it's, actually legit. Let's be honest here. This is a fucking superhuman world. I refuse to believe it's, just her thinking she's filthy. But why? There's nothing weird about sunflowers wilting and goldfish dying.
それらが短い期間にルチアに
集中しすぎた。
But wasn't that a long time ago? We're in high school now. Why is she still so worried about those bad childhood memories? Because I guarantee you, we're gonna do something and then the fucking thing's gonna die. We're gonna have an animal touch. She's gonna touch an animal and it's gonna die. Shizuru eats the last bite of her crepe. As she finishes, there's nothing for me to do except watch all the kids playing in the park. What are they playing? It looks kind of like tag, but they clearly aren't using the same rules. They're cheating. They're probably using rules that no one else can understand. Young children will come up with special rules that only they can understand.
Moshi, mata hana ni furete, karete shimau koto ga atta nara, Lucia wa sore ga osoroshii.
So that's why she acts like that. That's why she doesn't want to touch flowers. She couldn't enter the flower bed to get the soccer ball. That's why she can't touch animals. She can't hold an adorable cat when someone offers her one.
I just heard it, so I don't know how hard it was to get that time. I don't know all of it. But for Lucia, it's just a deep heart wound. It's not a mistake.ルチアもルチアなりにその傷と向かい合ってきた。忘れようとしたり、乗り越えようとしたり、いろいろと試みてきた。その挙句、一番自分に優しく向かい合えたのが、あの手袋だった。
If she doesn't touch anything, then nothing will wilt or die. That can't be right. That's like admitting that she killed that sunflower and goldfish.
さっき小太郎は、ひまわりが枯れたり、金魚が死んだりするのはよくあることだと自分で言った。ならもし、悪い偶然がもう一度起こったなら、どうするのか。
When she says it like that, I can't answer. So, she's going to live with the rest of her life afraid of touching any other living thing. Seriously?
Lucia, だって本当は花が好きだし、動物だって大好きだ。Lucia の部屋はそういうものへの憧れで満ちている。
それで、部屋には造花やぬいぐるみがいっぱいあるって言うんですか?
Yeah, apparently, so everything you're mad at about is just a misunderstanding. Look, Shizuru is 100% not telling everything. Let's be honest here. It's 100% impossible that there is not something of truth that something with her hands, like,Either she sucks life energy or something. I would just say probably sucks life energy. It was like a slow progression, I would say. Although I don't know how fast like the animals died or whatever, but I just imagine it would be like sucking them and weakens them and then they just die. Like, there's no way that's not real. She's a part of Guardian. Of course they're gonna use her.Including the cat incident. Class rep likes cats, and she didn't want to hold it. She was just afraid it might die if she did. And it probably would.
So, the cat got me and hit me on the ground. I don't have to get to
the cat. That's right, it was all just a sequence of unfortunate coincidences. She's not a bad person. I mean, she's not a bad person, but it's not coincidences.Shia seems to be understanding me now. But her emotions aren't so simple that this resolves the conflict instantly. Jeez. Why is it so hard to get people to forgive each other?
幼い頃に非常に気の毒な事情があったってのは、まあ、理解しました。
You do?
でも、納得しろと言われたら、はい、そうですかと頷きたい気分でもありません。
And what do you want?
そういう話は、当人同士がするもんです。違いますか？
Shai's expression softens a little. At first glance, she's shrugging her shoulders in frustration, but I know she's beginning to understand. Exactly. If things get any tenser between you two, I'll suffocate.
あなた、その程度の理由で私とこの花さんにおせっかい焼いて回ってるんですか？ 物好きな人です。
Yeah, I'm willing and able to handle anything in this city.
ご町内のことは何でも？ じゃあ、この花さんのお家、どこか教えてもらえます？
Why?
まあ、 お見舞いにでも行ってやろうかと思いまして。
Glassrap was absent today. Ostentatiously. She has a cold. Fuck off. But given everything that happened, it's probably an emotional reason. Oh, really? Jaya seems to have been made that assumption.
私も事情を知らずに言い過ぎましたし、責任取って私が自ら足を運ぶことにします。それでいいですか？
Of course, that's perfect.
私まだこっちに来て日が浅いですし、街とかわかりません。あなたが案内してください。
I don't actually know where it is. But I can ask Shizuru. Shizuru wants her to have more friends. This is gonna go terrible. She knows this problem prevents Classrep from making friends, but she still wants her to make more. I'm sure she'd be willing to let me to tell me. Okay, shall we go right after school? Chaya still looks unhappy, but she's probably feeling better on the inside. Now she just wants an opportunity to forgive Classrep. And I'll give it to her.